Hey everybody, so I'm back to film my July favorites. It feels like it's been forever since I filmed the favorites video just because I missed June favorites, and I've never actually missed a favorites video in a long time. But I really didn't have any favorites in June, nothing worth making a video, and I just got back from my California mini vacation right when June was ending, and I was just a little overwhelmed. But I do have a couple things I can show you guys this time around. This video will be posted before July is technically over, but the next 4 days or whatever amount of days are left in this month won't really change what my favorites are. So I'm posting this a bit early because I won't have time to post it later. Starting off with skincare, I have a new favorite dark spot treatment whitening gel. And I've been using it for a couple months actually, so it's not really like a new thing in July. But I haven't shown you guys yet. So it's this little tiny tube. I think it's by C plus M. It says it's their scar whitening gel serum. I really am not that big of a fan of the packaging because it's a rolly ball type of packaging. I haven't seen this in a long time. I haven't seen this since they made lip glosses like this with like little glitters in it. But it's like literally you roll ball and then stuff comes out. And sometimes it won't come out at first. So you have to shake it down and then roll. If you think about it, it's not the most hygienic thing in the world to just continuously roll it on your face. You could always roll it on your hand and then apply it, but pretty much what you do with this is apply it on any hyperpigmentation spots you have on your face, like acne, scarring. That's what I primarily use it for because I always have this battle with acne scars. And if you watched my last skincare routine video, which has changed a little bit, I have to do an updated one soon. I was using the Face Shop's Night Spot Eraser, which I still think is a great product. It's a bit harder for me to get. It takes a lot longer for it to arrive here because I have to order it off of eBay. I still like that, but this works a little bit faster for me. I saw noticeable results a lot quicker. I don't exactly know how many weeks. It just depends on how long that scarring's been there, how dark it is, etc., etc. It's different for everyone. I do think it works pretty well. I like to apply it right on whatever forming scar is happening after I have a breakout or something like that. But I like it. I think it's pretty good price-wise, and as a product, I will probably continue using it because I do see a lot of results. I have no acne scarring on this side of my face anymore. I still have a little bit on this side. Of course, I know you guys can't see it, but so that's the only skincare product that I have to show you guys this month. But into the makeup section, I've been loving my new Urban Decay makeup palette. Isn't it gorgeous? Gorgeous. If you haven't seen it yet, this is their 15th anniversary edition palette. It's a limited edition palette.
So cute.
I think this might be my favorite palette Urban Decay has ever released. And yes, I'm saying I like this more than makeup palette just because I used this a lot when it first came out, but I don't use it that much anymore. I mean, a lot of people use it every day, but I don't know, I just don't grab it as much. And I love this palette. A lot of people get worried with Urban Decay palette, thinking like the colors are always really similar. I will post two reviews in the info box, one by Jen from Head to Toe where she does swatches in a video, and then another blog post by Tim Talia who does great swatches. And she mentions possible dupes, but most of the possible dupes that you're thinking of have different undertones. Like if you think this looks like this or this looks like that, they're just slightly different, but I do love the palette as a whole because I think the colors are just great. You have colorful colors, you have lighter neutrals, and you have like the darker, smokier colors. Like I said, it is limited edition, so once they stop selling it, they will stop selling it. I think it came out July 12th online, and I bought it like earlier in the morning because I was ironically awake that early. And then it sold out by like 12 noon on their website. And they're going to be releasing it in like Sephora and Ulta, but they won't be there that long. I don't exactly know when it will be in the stores either. I know a few people have picked it up. I really do think it's worth it. It's $55, a little pricey, but I mean, most of Urban Decay's palettes are typically around that. The cool thing about this palette is that there's this little open area here. I don't want to pop it out because I might break a nail. But after you're done with the shadows, if you want to take it out and just use it as like a jewelry box, because there's like a felt lining on the inside, you could do that. Another makeup item that I've been using a lot this month and in the month of June is this primer by Victoria's Secret. It's their Victoria's Secret Pro Airbrush face primer. It has SPF 20, which is pretty good for a primer. Looks a lot like the Smashbox primer packaging wise, and it acts a lot like the Smashbox primer. It feels kind of similar to the Makeup Forever primer as well. It has that almost silicone feel to it. It's very like lays on top of your skin, kind of watery. I think this is the most watery out of the other ones I've named. But I haven't broken out from it. I'm acne prone. I don't think I have a problem with silicone type of products. If you do have problems with those type of products, definitely don't use it. It's very watery. I really feel like it creates this barrier between my makeup and my face, which is primarily what I use a primer for. I don't really need it that much for any like large pores or anything like that. I don't have that many trouble areas, luckily, but I do see that it makes all your fine lines or pores seem a little bit more hidden or covered. You can't feel them as much. It creates this little perfect smooth base for your foundation or your powder or concealer. I like it the most when I'm wearing just powder foundation. Maybe it's a little bit concealer. That's what I've been doing a lot lately. I haven't been wearing foundation that much just because with the hotter weather, I prefer just a lighter feeling. It does also work well with liquid foundation. I think it's $12, which isn't that bad. You can definitely try it out in the store. I'm sure you're gonna feel like it's really greasy. But if you give it a little bit after you rub it in, you'll start to feel that it's not that greasy anymore. It definitely sinks in and you have this like smooth little feeling, but right away you're gonna be like, oh my god, it's like not sinking in at all. It takes like 5 minutes. You gotta give it a little time. A concealer I've been loving this month is by Revlon, and it's their Photo Ready Concealer. I was gonna do a review on this concealer, but I think could sum it all up in this video. It's really affordable. I think it's $7 to $8, available at most drugstore. The shade I'm in is medium. It's like a lipstick packaging. It looks like one of their lipstick packagings. I'm wearing it today under some powder. And I like it because it's super creamy. It slides on like butter, as you can see. And it's like a full coverage concealer, which is awesome. It blends out really well. I'm wearing it under my eyes and over a little bit of acne scarring. And it doesn't cake up under my eyes, which I like. It doesn't really settle in the fine lines. I think if you use a primer underneath it, it really doesn't go anywhere. It's definitely just a great quality concealer for drugstore. I would say this is becoming my favorite drugstore concealer. Another concealer that I've been liking this month is the NYX Concealer in a Jar. I got this sent to me a while ago. I reviewed it on my blog a couple months ago. And I do actually like it. I see a lot of people use this a lot. I have it in two shades. I have it in beige and medium. This is beige and this is medium. Medium is more pinky salmon undertone, good for the under eyes. And I prefer beige for any face correcting because it has a yellow undertone, which matches me pretty well. I wore this in my last video under some powder. The packaging is really tiny, so it's really hard to fit your finger in and get any of it. I wouldn't recommend sticking your finger in at all, aside from the whole hygiene issue. I cut my finger. I got a huge paper cut with this packaging because the rim is kind of sharp, and I try to twist my finger, and I ended up with this huge cut, which was uncomfortable. So just take like a brush, a concealer brush, or a fluffy blending brush, and just use it that way. It's much easier. I use just an E40 by Sigma and just use that. It's really good for the under eyes. I like the Photo Ready concealer a little bit more for the under eyes because the NYX one, if you do go a little too heavy, it would cake up on you, but it just depends on how you're applying it. I think I'm going to do a more in-depth review comparing it to the Benefit Erase Paste soon, so look for that video. Last miscellaneous favorite of this month is ironically a sponge, a bright yellow sponge. And this is by EcoTools. It comes in a pack of three. They're just facial sponges. And they're not harsh at all. They're very soft, nice and round, not weak. It hasn't fallen apart on me. None of them actually have. And what I use it for is just for my cleanser in the morning. Like, I scrub my cleanser on and then I just get the sponge wet and I just wipe it off. It does like very soft exfoliating and then it helps clean everything off. I also use one for when I use mud mask and I just clean that one off with a little rinsing. I think it's like $5. I don't know. I will put all the pricing for everything I mentioned in this video in the box. I've been liking these sponges. They're really nice for just like really quick rinses and such. If you don't feel like breaking out your Clarisonic or something like that, just grab a sponge. Much easier. When they dry, they get a little stiff, but as soon as you put them in the water, it's back to being nice and squishy. Sally's Beauty Supply also sells facial sponges like this. From first impressions between those and the EcoTool ones, which I picked this up at Target, I prefer these. Just saying. You can probably find them at like CVS or anywhere else you can find EcoTools. And those are my favorites. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in a later video.